Terra Delta. You arrive as the little one said you would. Come upstairs to the ticket booth, and I will offer what I know of you.
I'll take three this time. Do you understand that? Three. I just tell her, baby, I want a child. End the discussion. Just like that.
Now most who survive are like this. Splicers. They're drug addicts. Vicious animals.
Dwells within us all. Remember, we reject the gene. We reject the self. We reject the tyrant.
I'm told that the people grow tense and isolated in the absence of the sun. Now they clamor for a psychiatrist. Do they miss the state censor, I wonder? Wartime seizure of private assets? Or the Cheka police vanishing them in the night? Regardless, this lamb woman is said to be the foremost practitioner in her field. Fine. If she can quiet the rattling of the Great Chain's weakest links, I will leave her to it.
I know you. That symbol on your hand marks you a dead man. 10 years, Subject Delta, since I watched you put a gun to your head and pull the trigger. But take heart. Out of your pain, paradise was born. I don't know how you survived, but your suffering is over now. These men will ease your burden. Please understand that, like all I have done, this is an act of love.
It is Sophia Lam. She has found you. Now you know of the enemy we share, Sophia Lam. The camera in your helmet allows me to watch through your eyes and help you to fight her. Careful. Security cameras belong to Lam. But if you are clever, they can be made to serve you.
Who's there?
It's me, Eleanor. I know you're awake in there. I can feel it. Mother won't be able to toy with you like that ever again. This plasmid is for you. If I'm right, you can use it now. Please, find me.
throw objects at foes. You can even catch grenades and throw them back.
Garden full of cutesy little brats, and went up happy ever after. He was a pet. End my story.
Oh!
White is not black, Dr. Lamb. Down is not up, and straw is not gold. Look around you. Rapture is no miracle. It is a product of reason. Impossible unless one and one are two, and A equates to A.
And yet, alone, each man is a prisoner to bias. Dream, delusion, or the pain of a phantom limb. To one man, they are as real as rain. Reality is consensus, and the people are losing faith. Take a walk, Andrew. It is raining in Rapture, and you have simply chosen not to notice.
Lamb is using the splicers against you. Most big daddies are like her slaves, guarding the little ones. But someone has awakened you.
I know of your bond with Eleanor Delta. To save yourself, you will come for her. But Eleanor has a destiny. One you cannot share. There is no place for you in paradise.
These people are hooked on some kind of genetic wonder drug called Adam. I've read the word splicer scribbled on walls like a warning. One of them cornered me and, Christ, his face! I had a gun, but I choked. And then out of nowhere, we both heard this singing. And he took off like hell on wheels. It sounded like a kid. A little girl. Cindy's alive. I know it in my gut.
In ethical psychiatry, we must account for the role of evolution. Depression, fits of panic, sexual pathos, all responses to ancient selection pressure. The irony is that this theory is why Ryan's people invited me here. They mistake my study of natural law for the worship of competition. Remember, Eleanor, one must know the beast before it can be slain.
Elevator.
Thank you.
myself! I'm done! I can't get along without you! I made your numbers, you fucking... Come on! Come on! I was not talking to you! I was just sitting down! Why do they always gotta leave? That's not the last one! Please!
Now, here is what the children tell me. You are a very old Big Daddy, bonded for life to a single little one. When you are apart for too long, your body begins to shut down like a coma. As long as the girl is in rapture, you are trapped here as well. The name of your little one is Eleanor Lamb, daughter of Sophia. She is kept at Fontaine Futuristics on the other side of the city. You must go there and save her before it is too late.
Using the new little ones for something, and I have returned to rescue them. If I do not, more children will die for my sins, and the rapture nightmare it will repeat forever. Now, we must talk.
Citizens of Rapture, this is Subject Delta. Behind that mask hides an enemy of the people, without soul or sympathy. It is a beast apart. And as family, we must tear out its jaw and drive it back into the sea.
Lamb will take this place apart to find you. Please hold back the splicers until we escape.
Thank you.
Thank you. Now I must leave you, and I am sorry for this, but there are others I must help before the city drowns. This man Sinclair, he is an ally, and will guide you to Eleanor. Goodbye, Herr Delta, and good luck.
Well, look at you. A bona fide knight in armor, complete with iron horse. The name's Augustus Sinclair, sport, Esquire. Old Tannenbaum and I share an interest in the old Fontaine building, the very same place you'll find Eleanor Lamb. I think you and I can do business. Take the train to Ryan Amusements. I'll see you shortly.
Whoa there! Now better apply the brakes unless you're aiming to dash yourself against that glacier up ahead. As you can see, Chief, the station here is iced over. To reach Eleanor Lamb at Fontaine headquarters, we'll have to clear the way. Now, in order to melt that ice, you'll need a plasmid like a handful of hellfire. We used to sell a fine old product called Incinerate in the amusement park up yonder. Go on and find a way in. I've already been on all the rides.
Cloud! Fucking Cloud! You think you're so funny! You think I won't slug you one?
Welcome to Ryan Amusements. Insert your ticket now. Half price for children under 3.
You're a rare old model, son. Alpha Series, I believe. Now, Rapture's full of scientific wonderments just like you. And if we can sell them to the world at my price, well, curing your condition ought to be a cakewalk. Once we find Eleanor, the sky's the limit.
I was hired to engineer a park the likes of which no man has seen. Now all I do is watch over it like a grizzled sheepdog. My first line of mechanical puppets made the children here coo with wonder. But Ryan thought my vision was immature. Antiquated, he said. This place could have been something magical. But instead, he turned it into a school. No, a cathedral. Dedicated to himself.
Looks like you're out of hack darts. I'll send you some more by Pneumo.
Can I come out to play again, Mr. B?
Jim dandy. That'll get you in the park. But buying incinerate's gonna cost Adam. It's a sort of genetic goo that lets you rewrite whatever God gave you. The little sisters carry the stuff, as you may recall, so you'll need to locate one. I heard whispering near the El Dorado Lounge. Have a look.
What's that? Listen up! Choppers! Get yourselves hit! No fuck-ups this time! Daddy's home! Take aim! Fire! You're the gift!
Bless me, Lord!
Hey, we were just getting started! Hey, come back! I don't have it! You can't ignore me! Come on! Come on! You got a special problem, huh?
Baby?
Huh? You fight like a baby! Why not? Just
come back.
I am Andrew Ryan. Welcome to Ryan Amusements. Please, enjoy the park.
Ryan wakes one night while cruising the Atlantic in his steam liner, the Olympian. His sleep interrupted with a singular purpose. Here, he shouts to his crewmen as he wipes sleep from his eyes. Full stop. We begin building here. Refitted for heavy construction, the Olympian returns with a new cargo. A state-of-the-art submersible platform, nicknamed the Sinker, ferries supplies and workers to the seafloor, fathoms below. After initial supplies have been brought to the seafloor, the platform is